In that, a new concept are developed to transform such graph, which are non-numerical to mathematical object, into related numbers that are topological index or molecular descriptors. So this index or molecular descriptors are just numeric value. Okay, so they assign for corresponding graph of chemical compound. Okay, so topological index has been successfully used for estimating several physical properties, including normal body temperature and data related to the biological activities as well. Okay. Okay. So there are some types of topological indices. Okay. One of them is based on n vertex degrees of edges. Okay. And then one of the best known topological indices based on n vertex degrees is Rayleigh index. Okay. So this index is actually the most studied in the chemical graph theory. Okay, so what is actually the problem for theory of topological indices? Okay, so there are two ways to the for research in the topological indices. One direction is they go for chemical properties or boiling properties, more on application. And another direction is they try to find more properties on the topological indices. Okay, so for the mathematical properties of topological indices, they are concerned with axiomal structures under certain constraints that can maximize or minimize the given topological index. Then they define for the best the possible lower and upper bound. Then they also try to find a relation between the different topological indices. Okay. Then Bukeswi and Fortula introduce a number of topological index based on the n vertex degrees of the edges. And they presented some basic properties. So we call this index as geometric arithmetic index, or short form just GA index. And this index is defined by GA of G summation 2 times square of du dv over du plus dv. Okay, so the summation extends over all edges. UV in G and du dv are degrees of vertices that are connected with each UV. Then we know that from this definition, it consists from geometric mean of n vertex degrees of each UV as numerator, and arithmetic means of n vertex degrees of the each UV as denominator. Okay, and then this one for result from Kusubi and Fortula. So where they obtain the bound for GA of G. So the upper bound is achieved if and only if G is empty, and upper bound is achieved when G is complete graph. Then they also obtain the theory 2. Okay, so this is a different bound for G of G, where the lower bound is achieved if and only if G is a star. Upper bound is achieved if and only if G is complete graph. Then the theory 3 is for the result for 3, where they obtain the bound for G of G, where G is a 3. And upper bound is achieved if and only if T is a star, and upper bound is achieved if and only if T is a path. Then the theory 4, they consider chemical tree with n vertices. So chemical tree is actually the tree with the degree not more than 4, at most 4. So the degree cannot exceed 4. So they call as chemical 3. So the researchers in chemical graph theory, if we say chemical 3, they understand, they know. Okay? Then they find when the T is chemical 3, they obtain the bound for GA. So lower bound is achieved for trees that contains only vertices of degree 1 and 4. Upper bound is achieved if and only if T is a path. Okay? And there are some more results on GA index. For example, result by Yuan, Dinit, etc., Das, Gutmann, and Fatula, and then many more. Okay, so all these results are related to the bound for GA index. Okay, so this is what I'm doing. There is a maximum values of GA index of bicyclic graph. Okay, we have the method. We use the method of pendant edge. Okay, so pendant vertex is the vertex of degree one, and then the pendant edge is edge incident with the pendant vertex. Then the path U1, U2 to UR in the graph G is said to be pendant path at U1 if DU1 at least greater equal to 3, DUR is equal to 2, for 2 to R minus 1, and DUR is equal to 1. Okay, so this concept or this method actually was introduced by Du and others in 2011. They used the term pendant path. Then I feel that I want to say this is a method because they use this pendant path to generate the graph of bicyclic graph. Okay, then they introduce lemma 1. So lemma 1 is if there are k pendant path in graph D, then they find the upper bound of GA. Okay, so this is the upper bound. And n vertex connected graph is bicyclic if it possesses n plus 1 edges. Okay, then we obtain lemma 2 for bicyclic graph. Okay, if there are k pendant path in n vertex bicyclic graph, then they have upper bound for GA of bicyclic graph. They just replaced by here. Okay, so currency of EG for bicyclic graph is n plus 1. So they just apply lemma 1 and they obtain the lemma 2. Okay, then in the paper from Du and others 2011, okay, published in Math Chemistry Journal, Match Communication in Mathematical Chemistry. They obtain classification of bicyclic graph. Okay, so they obtain B1, B2, B3. Okay, B4, B5, B6. Okay. So this is how they classify all the bicyclic graph from lemma 2. Okay, so they obtain this result, theorem 5. Among the set of n vertex bicyclic graph, they obtain the first maximum, B1. So B1 got two graph, two type of the bicyclic graph with maximum GA index, that is B11, B21. Then they find for the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth, and the sixth maximum. Okay, and in the proof of the their theorem, they consider three cases, that is bicyclic graph with no pending path, one pending path, and two pending path. Then we extend the result. So we just consider more. We add one more case. There is three pending path. Okay. So when we add one more case, there is three pending path. We obtain more matching values for basic graph. Okay. So we are able to determine more matching values from the 7th to the 35th. So 35th maximum GA indices. So the same, we use the same method as done by Du and others, where we obtain more classification of bicyclic graph. Okay, so we classify more graph, B7, B8 until B. So I'm not showing all graph here. So until we have more 14 types of bicyclic graph from 7 maximum to 35th maximum. Then we obtain the results. Sorry, this is from us, not from Du. So this is our results. We obtain 7 maximum, 8 maximum to 25th maximum G index. Okay, so in the proof of our theorem, we use the same idea, the same strategy. Okay, so when we consider k at least greater or equal to 4 pending path, and then we actually have a new upper bound. So it means that we will obtain more maximum values. Okay. Then this is the case. Case 1, there is no pending path. Case 2, there is actually 1 pending path. Case 3, there are actually 2 pending paths. Case 4, there are actually 3 pending
paths. I have some question. Okay, more basic. What's a bicyclic graph? Two cycles, is it?
Actually the general form of bicyclic graph is any graph with and plus 1 is just any graph you have.
Or n minus 1 is 3,
yeah,
or
yeah.
More, okay.
Yeah,
okay, yeah. Okay. So there could be 3 cycles, so potentially.
Yeah.
1, 2, and 3.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, then what's the next question? Oh yeah, so far is
QSAR,
you refer to?
Yeah, QSAR is a quantity. Is a quantitative. Yeah, this is a term for in application chemistry.
I see.
Application related
so
chemistry.
Can you give an intuition of why it's important to study that the geometric and reflecting?
Okay,
I have
said earlier that there is actually. There are two directions for topological indices, topological index.
Okay.
So the one direction is the people are interested to study chemical application.
Yeah.
Application for topological index, where they can predict the biological and chemical properties of chemical compound. And then another direction is people in graph theory, they are interested to find more properties.
Yeah.
For example, they go for bound, and then they go for which graph. Which graph give you the maximum or minimum topological index?
Let me phrase this question. How does this graph arise from the chemical structure? Is this how the molecules are built up?
Actually in chemistry they have like chemical compound. For example, octanes, alkanes, and then they have the structure.
Oh, so these are
So this actually the problem arises from chemistry or physical problems. Okay, then in graph theory they try to figure out which corresponding graph correspond to this all chemical compounds. And then suddenly, researchers in graph theory, they are more interested with mathematical properties. So there is actually a slightly a gap between those who are interested with application and graph theory.
Right.
So we they can go two ways.
Any other questions? Okay, if not, let's thank our speaker. Okay, so the next talk is that, let me see.